Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to BlackCatsNetwork.com. It's a Tuesday afternoon, and we're here at Gorville High School in Justin Dale Shouse Memorial Field for a Black Diamond Conference matchup. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Brian Murley. J.R. Russell is at golf practice. He'll be here a little bit later. But today, the Black Cats take on the Pioneers of Trico in a Black, like I said, in a Black Diamond Conference matchup. Black Cats come in 3-1 in the conference, and I'm not quite for sure what the Pioneers record is, but it doesn't matter because you got to win in every Black Diamond game that you can if you want to win this conference. Because next week, ZR comes to town, and that's going to be a battle. But we're glad you all are here with us tonight. This afternoon, the game got moved up half an hour due to the impending weather. So just to let you know, that's why we are on early today. But we'll hopefully bring you the full thing. We're going to hear a word from our sponsors, and I'll come back because I got a couple other things I've got to get up done and ready to go. But you're watching the Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com, a free service of Gorville School. Like more information, contact us on our Facebook page or email us at BlackCatsNetwork@gmail.com or contact at GorvilleSchools.com. We'll be back in about 5 minutes at the start of the game here on BlackCatsNetwork.com.
Southern Trust Bank is the only bank in Johnson County that is locally owned. Community banks touch every corner of our lives. They support us as we turn our life's goals into accomplishments. Goals like going to college, opening a small business, buying a home, planning a wedding, or having a baby. For your first car to life after retirement, our community bank is there for all your life's milestones. Southern Trust Bank is located in Gorville, Vienna, and Marion. Come out and visit the friendly faces at your local branch. FDIC Equal Housing Lender. Black Cat alum Noel Pease is proud to have his company, Pease Contracting LLC, support the Black Cat Network. Noel can handle any and all of your needs when it comes to lawn care, landscape, snow removal, or excavation. Reach out to Noel at 618-364-5140 for a free estimate. For grass, gravel, snow, or dirt, use Pease Contracting at a price that won't hurt. Don't get caught late in the game and find yourself running out of your favorite adult beverage. Stock up in advance by visiting The Oasis, conveniently located just north of Gorville on Route 37. The Oasis prides itself on providing a large variety and quality selection of adult beverages, including hard-to-find allocated spirits. If they don't carry what you're looking for, just ask. They'd be happy to try to get it for you. You'll experience quality, service, and convenience at The Oasis. The Oasis, a must stop before your next adult gathering. The Gorville News is a supporter of the Black Cats Network and exclusively covers the Gorville Black Cats athletic program. If you have any news about Gorville, the Lake of Egypt, or surrounding area, let's tell the world and email them at contact@gorvillenews.com. The Gorville News, your only Gorville newspaper. This year, more than ever, make sure you're well-stocked with all your game-time munchie needs. And you can do that by shopping locally and supporting small businesses, just like the Gorville Food Market. Conveniently located in the heart of Gorville, just down from the city park, the Gorville Food Market has everything you need to make streaming your Black Cat sporting event experience a great success. The Gorville Food Market offers a full grocery experience and boasts the best quality butcher department around that serves only fresh meat, never frozen. They're open 7 days a week for your convenience. Come visit the Gorville Food Market. Dean Harper Auction is pleased once again to sponsor the Black Cat Network. Dean Harper Auction has been in business since 1967 and does both online auction as well as live auctions. They can help you sell your estate, household, real estate, as well as your farm. You can contact Dean Harper Auction at www.deanharperauction.com. Give Robin or Dean a call at 618-527-6500 for a no-cost consultation. Dean Harper Auction, serving Johnson County and the surrounding area, as well as supporting your Gorville Black Cats. Remember, everything sells with Harper. Have you got a commercial or home project that requires more equipment and muscle than you have available? Well, you don't have to break your back to get the job done. You can save time and money with Suits Equipment Rental. Suits Equipment Rentals has all the tools and equipment you'll need to tackle any project, big or small. Call them today at 618-992-4433. Timber! If you have a need for attention to any tree issues on your property, Shawnee Tree Services is here to help. The folks at Shawnee Tree Services are arbor care specialists, providing all types of tree services for Johnson County and the surrounding areas. Whether it's a simple tree trimming or complete removal, Shawnee Tree Service has the answer for you. Contact them today at 618-694-6343. Why would you call anyone else? Once again, Wiffle Boys Pizza is the official pizza of the Black Cats Network. The Southern Illinois original, located in the heart of downtown Goreville, offers pizza, subs, salads, soups, wings, and appetizers. You can place your order the old-timey way by phone at 618-995-9433 or order online. Download the Wiffle Boys app, available through Android and iOS, and look in the Apple Store or Google Play. They've also added a lunch menu and are open for lunch Wednesdays through Sunday at 11 o'clock. Call them now at 618-995-9433. Wiffle Boys Pizza, hometown, homegrown, and always homemade.
Goreville has a new option for a home-cooked breakfast or lunch at the Goreville Grill, located behind H&H Fuel across from Wiffle Boys. The Goreville Grill offers a full breakfast and lunch menu, including biscuits and gravy, the Black Cat Burger, and homemade pies. They're open Monday through Friday from 6 to 2 and Saturday 6 to 11. Call ahead at 618-964-0105 and you can pick up your meal at their drive-thru. Check out their daily lunch specials posted on their Facebook page, The Goreville Grill. Friendly service, quality food, and made with love. Well, we're getting closer to the beginning of this ball game here. Trico is wrapping up their infield, and JR should be here about 4:30 or so. He had golf practice, that's where we're at with that. Black Cats coming in. They've been playing up and down, I would say. Some games we look great, other games we don't. It's been a while since we've been at home. They did have a home game against Johnson City last Friday, but I already had a prior commitment with Saluki softball and was unable to attend that since it was a rescheduled game. They are 3-1 in the Black Diamond with their with two defeat. They've defeated Vienna twice, defeated Johnson City once, and lost to Johnson City. And so it's essential that they win these two games against Trico this week, with ZR coming to town next week. ZR, very good ball club. ZRC, I should say, since they do co-op with Christopher. But the first pitch isn't too far away from here. It is windy as all get out. As you can see by those flags out there, that wind has changed direction about 20 times since we've come up here in the press box. But it is looking very, very windy here at Justin Dale Childs Memorial Field. So that'll really depend on how much I can boost that outdoor mic this afternoon and tonight. We're glad you all are with us here on Blackcast Network. Blackcast Network is a free service to Goreville School. Like more information, contact us on our Facebook page or email us at blackcastnetwork@gmail.com or contact at goorevilleschools.com. I'm going to step away, do my PA duties. That's next time you'll hear my voice here on blackcastnetwork.com.
Conference champion, Goreville Black Cats. Today, the Black Cats take on the Pioneers from Trico in a Black Diamond Conference matchup. Coaches, players, and fans who follow the BWATS Ride expectations will represent their school well and create a positive game experience. Represent your school community through positive interaction with the opposing fans and players. Use positive cheers, chants, songs, or gestures. Display modesty and victory and graciousness in defeat. Respect and acknowledge the integrity and the judgment of the officials, and exhibit positive behavior before, during, and after the contest. If you're visiting here with us today at Justin Dale Shoutouts Memorial Field, the bathrooms are located at the concession stand area, which is located behind the first base side. We ask you to please return all foul balls as quickly as possible to either dugout, so we'll get them back in play as soon as possible. And finally, we ask you to help keep the ballpark looking clean and beautiful by placing all your trash in the trash cans located strategically throughout the park. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight in the concession stand, we do have barbecue and barbecue nachos. Mmm, good. Black Cat fans, don't forget you can follow the Black Cats all season long by downloading the Game Changer app to your phone or your mobile device. You can download that at your iOS store or your Google Play store, or download on your computer at www.gc.com. This time, I'd ask everyone to please rise, move your caps, and direct your attention to the flagpole located in center field as we honor America, the playing of our national anthem. Let's play ball! The official today's game are Mr. Kenny Miner and Mr. Paul Burkhalter. Now, let's get the start line first for your Goreville Black Cats. Leading off and playing second base, number 5, Hunter Francis. Batting second to play shortstop, number 12, Cole Tripp. On the hill today, batting third for your Black Cats, number 4, Drake Moss. Batting fourth and playing first base, number 33, Levi Damon. Batting fifth and playing center field, number 28, Nick Gower. Batting sixth and behind the plate for your Black Cats, number 2, Tyler Suits. Batting seventh and playing right field, number 11, Drake Buffington. Batting 8th and playing 3rd base, number 31, Gary Church. And batting 9th and playing left field, double 0, Grant Crock. Starting for the Pioneers, leading off and playing shortstop, number 12, Mason Cranawater. Got the plate for the Pioneers, number 23, Bo Cullen. Playing center field, number 7, Ty Dorner. Your designated hitter, number 33, Cannon Wilson. Playing second base, number 32, Ethan Cranawater. On the hill for the Pioneers today, number 18, Tyler Bowerman. Batting sixth to play first base, number 25, Kate Estel. Batting seventh to play third base, number 35, Caden McBride. Batting eighth, left fielder, number 11, Caden Starkey. And batting ninth to play right field, number 22, Donovan Jimenez. Leading off the top, the first inning for the Pioneers, shortstop number 12, Mason Cranawater.
All There you go. Starting lineups for the both teams there. Drake Moss on the hill today. He sets. He delivers. Fires the first pitch. That's a called strike one. So what you want to do? You're going to get ahead. Stay ahead. It's the name of the game. Get ahead. Stay ahead. Here's the pitch from Moss. That ball's outside. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Jenna's doing our scoreboard today for the game until JR gets here. Thankful for that. Be one less thing I have to worry about. That ball is fouled back. Strike two. One ball, two strikes. Yeah, we're trying to get this game in early because of the impending weather that's coming in, so you all stay safe tonight. Here's the pitch from Moss. That ball is fouled back straight into the protective netting, and we'll do it again. Trying to find my in-between music for on my phone. We'll try to keep you updated on the girls' game as well that's happening across the street. Oh, nice pitch. Just a bit high. Two balls, two strikes. Here's the pitch from Moss. Ball down. Full count. Moss delivers. Ball high. First one is a walk.
Nobody for the Pioneers. The catcher, number 23, Bo Cohen.
Bo Cohen steps in. Bats lefty. I'm sure he's a righty being a catcher. Moss on the hill. Short lead over at first base. Here's the pitch on the ball in the outside corner. Ball one. Try to get just my camera guy's not here, so I got to remember to move that camera just a smidgen so you all can see the first base over there. Grant Wetter goes. Suit scoops the low pitch, and there's a stolen base for Mason Kranewider. Runner in scoring position, ball two. Two balls, no strikes to Cohen. Here's the pitch from Moss. High and outside, ball three. Moss comes set. Walks in good pitch. Must have been low. Tiny strike zone. Very reminiscent of the game, girls softball game on Saturday I was at SIU.
Nobody for the Pioneers. Center fielder number seven, Ty Dorner.
Ty Dorner steps in. Runners on first and second. Nobody out. Black Cats looking for and out anywhere here. Now the wind is blowing right to from there's the same pitch he just called a ball, but we'll take it. Strike one. Yeah, Saturday, Jenna, literally the pitchers had to throw through an area about this big to get a strike called, so they were all setting on it, and that's why SIU scored 20 runs because they were just setting on that pitch because they had to. I guess the umpire is not too worried about the weather because his strike zone is small. Moss steps off. That wind blowing. You can see that dust flying across the field. Glad we're up here out of that. Moss delivers. Swing and a miss. Strike two. One ball, two strikes. Nobody away. A runner at first and second. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike three. One away.
Now batting for the Pioneers, designated hitter, number 33, Cannon Wilson.
Cannon Wilson steps in. One away now. Ground ball. Get out of this. Would be great. First pitch from Moss. There's a strike on the outside corner. Moss comes set. Delivers. That ball is out. One ball, one strike. Moss delivers. Swing on. That ball's hit up the middle. It could be two. Has the Francis over to first. In time. Blackcats get.
Or the Pioneers get no runs on, no hits, no errors with one left on base. And we get to the bottom of the first.
Hunter Francis steps in. That ball is inside. He's sticking with it. No balls, one strike. I'll pull up game changer here for the girls. No, he called it a ball. I meant to say one ball. That ball is lifted. That's going to get over the head. That's going to be a ground rule double. Cole Tripp steps in after that ground rule double by Hunter Francis. Cole. That ball's lifted high to left field. That ball just keeps carrying, and that's going to be off the fence, and that's going to be a run for the Black Cats.
Now we bring the Black Cats, the pitcher number four.
back-to-back doubles. The wind played some havoc with that ball. I thought he had a beat and all. Next thing you know, the wind just lifted it and took it over his head. There's a strike. The girls are down 4-0 to Trico in the bottom of the first. So I'm going to assume there was probably a grand slam, maybe? I can go look back here. Nope, just a bunch of hits and scoring. So the Lady Black Cats trail by 4. One ball, one strike to Moss. Here's the pitch. Ball outside. Good stop by the catcher. Now he can't find it, but Cole was not going anywhere. Two balls and a strike. Here's the pitch. That ball's ripped to center field. That's going to be a base hit. And coach is going to hold up Cole Tripp at third base. Long throw in. Nice job there by Drake Moss.
Cloud, thunder, heavy rain, fiddle line between joy and pain. It's a lot of
Blackjacks. First baseman number 33.
You and Levi Damon. Live life through the night. Fiddle line with a lightning strike.
Levi steps in with the runner at first and third. Moss at first. Cole Tripp at third base. Throw back over to first base. Levi looking to pick up an RBI here. There goes Moss. That ball is ripped right in the hole. Levi hits it perfectly into the hole where nobody was. That's going to get Moss to third base. And another run for the Black Cats score.
Number for the Black Cats, center field number 26. Courtesy road for the pitcher, number 15, Taylor Sims.
Levi with a base hit RBI. And the shortstop went to cover second base, and Levi's like, thank you, I'll just take that hole right there. Levi on first. Here's the pitch. Ball inside to Gower. Ball one. Ball two. Excuse me. Not a very big lead for Levi over there. Gower swings and misses. Catcher fakes, throws to third. Strike one. Two balls and a strike. Gower hits that ball. It's going to get a run in. Probably going to be a double play. But the run does score. Three runs in for the Black Cats. Tyler fouls that one off, strike one. Let's see, so that was 4-6-3. Yeah. That ball is finds its way through the 5-6 hole and base hit for Tyler Suits. That brings up Drake Buffington.
Now but
Drake Buffington steps in. Tyler Suits at first base. Tyler goes. Throws through. Oh, I was going to say he got him.
Wildcats get three runs on four hits. No errors. No one. Five hits. No errors. No one left on base. We played one. Blackcats three. Pioneers zero.
Huh? Yeah. They shouldn't be very good.
Was that second baseman or the shortstop?
Okay, I just want. I think it should have been the second baseman. Blackcats get three in the bottom half of the third. Kyler Bowerman steps in for the Pioneers, the pitcher. Here's the pitch from Drake Moss, swing and a miss, strike one. Should be getting close to the time where JR is pulling up in the parking lot. I know there was fans there waiting on him when he got here, but I'm not seeing hide nor hair of him yet. But as long as he can get through that line, he's a man of the people. He'll stop and talk to everybody and sign all those autographs on his way up. One ball, two strikes to Bowerman. Swing and a miss, strike three.
Now batting for the Pioneers, first baseman number 25, Cade Estel.
Cade Estel steps in. Moss, a little bit better start here to the second inning. Settling in a bit. That ball's just outside. Ball one. Swung on, foul tip, strike one. One ball, one strike. Swung on, that ball is hit to Church. Church fields it. plenty of time. Throw over to first base, and that's going to be another bad throw. That's going to be an error.
Now batting for the Pioneers, third baseman number 35, Caden McBride.
Caden McBride steps in after that throw in. Church had plenty of time. That guy, not the fastest in the land, and he just did not make a good throw. Ball one. Here's the pitch. Ball inside. Two balls, no strikes. Estill at first base. Lady Blackcats trail 4-1 after one over across the way. There's strike two. Or strike one, I mean. Two balls and a strike. Finally gets through the autographs. Swing and a miss, strike two. Moss sets, he delivers. Swing and a miss, strike three. Two away, that brings up Caden Starkey.
Now ready for the Pioneers, left fielder number 11, Caden Starkey.
Good afternoon, Mr. Murley.
Good afternoon, JR.
Good afternoon, Black Cat Nation. Good afternoon, Jana. I just want nobody to point a finger. I walked up and we committed an error. That wasn't on me.
It wasn't you?
No. I guess we've been errorless to that point with a 3-0 score up there.
Yeah. Ball down in the dirt. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Two away here. Estill on first base. That ball's lifted. That's going to be foul out of play. And we'll do it again.
Surprised the wind didn't blow that back in. I'm telling you what, it is breezy out there today.
That's an understatement, sir.
It's a stiff breeze.
did you have to wear your seatbelt in the golf cart to keep
I
from
did.
Getting blown out?
I definitely did. I kept the windshield up, and I keep the windshield pointed to the wind.
Coach, why are you backing up everywhere you go? Well, I was trying to stay out of the wind. So.
Yeah.
That ball is fouled back. We'll do it again. One ball, two strike.
Looks like it's blowing dead out now. Shifting.
Well, it shifted about 17 times.
Yeah.
I think the last count was 37. Moss comes set. He delivers. Swung on. That's going to be popped up. Going to be Mosses, and we're out of it.
And a corn.
Pioneers get no runs and no hits, one error with one.
Black Cats retire the Trico Pioneers. We'll be back for the bottom of the second here on the BlackCatNetwork.com.
Wait, fielder number 11. Straight to the mall. For Buffy.
get you an excuse.
God, it's been a long day.
It's our new player, Mr. Moss Buffington.
Moss Buffington. Can't believe I did that.
That's all right. Shame on them for having the same first name.
That's right. I'll do him up good the next time up.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I did him up good the first time, but then we got caught stealing. You weren't here for that.
Stealing? Like an out-and-out steal?
Yeah. Well, he didn't, but Tyler did.
Okay.
I thought he was safe, but the umpire said differently.
One ball, two strikes. What's our recap on our three runs, man? How do we manage that?
Well, Hunter Francis led off with a ground rule double. Mm-hmm. Set that over there, as I got to get that back to Sean.
Sure.
And then, nice play by the second baseman.
And makes the throw.
All right, hold on. Let me get this.
Throws out Buffington for the first out.
Number three, Blackcats, third baseman number 31, Garrett.
Church. I'm going to guess if everybody's paying attention to that wind direction, it'd be Garrett Church right now.
All right, so anyway, JR.
Yes.
Ground rule double by Hunter Francis. Mm-hmm. And Cole Tripp hits a double, scores Hunter. Mm-hmm. Then Moss with a base hit. And then Levi Damon with a base hit, an RBI.
Ah.
And Nick Gower hits into a double. Oh, son of a Buddha, that hurt.
Got him on the rib cage, it
that
looked
hurt.
Like.
I'm going to hear Black Cats. Left fielder, double zero.
Boys are full of grit. They don't sit and wince when stuff like that happens. They just shake it off and run down and rub some dirt on it.
Well, as I say, Nick Gower hit into a double play, which scored our third run. And Tyler Suits got a base hit and then was gunned out at second base.
At second base.
All right. I just need to let that vent open. I've had it covered. And it was not letting any of that heat out.
Throw to first. Not in time. Gets away. Church is not going to be able to advance on that.
Nope.
Squirted away from the first baseman.
Squirted.
Boy, they're really playing the pull here. Look at that center fielder.
Good golly.
Way shade to left. Left fielder's hugging the fence, and the center fielder is almost in front of the scoreboard.
That ball's down, and the dirt ball, too. Man, I heard that hurt.
Yeah, it did. It was a thud.
I'm sure you heard that on the outside mic. Ball right.
Right.
He's going to have to hurry.
Get to get down. That call him safe.
I think he dropped
it. Must have dropped it.
Speaking of that, I forget what game it was. Where the guy goes into slide, and the guy, instead of waiting for him at the bag to tag the bag, he tries to tag him, and the guy does a swim move.
No, I missed
that. And rolls and never touched the...
Like a Matrix?
Yeah, it was a Matrix-type deal. It was pretty cool.
Cool.
Three balls, no strikes to Croc.
Runner in scoring position.
Here's the pitch. There's strike one.
I'm guessing a base hit to center, right center is going to score a run. My goodness, there's open. It looks like the Wild Wild West open prairie out there.
Wild Wild West. Swing and a miss, strike two. JR, you know, realize it's the first time we have been, have done a broadcast together in a long time.
Yeah,
it's been 11 days.
It feels like a very long time. One day away from
were you
Brian,
here from the Marion game?
No.
No, so it's been longer than that.
Mm-hmm. Ball four, high and inside. Going to bring Hunter Francis to the plate with runners in scoring position. First,
how about
second.
Second baseman, number five,
just one out. Yeah, Brian, one day away from using eternity for me, so you tack on 11.
But we did get to see each other last week.
Yes, we did. We went out on the town.
Yes, we did.
Marion Cultural and Civic Center and watched the Bee Gees tribute band.
That's right. They were good. They were good.
They were really good. It was an interesting night.
I did hit every high note. Yeah, he was up there.
He was staying alive.
And he looked like there was
a basic left field. They're going to have a little discussion here with the head coach and the home plate umpire as to that call.
He did not stop.
Coach not happy. Coach ain't going to get his way. Make the score 5-0 in favor of the Gorville Blackcats. Runners advance. Got Hunter Francis on third.
See, he didn't pause. That was an elongated pause, but.
And that one popped up. Is it going to stay in? Looks like it is. Nobody's going to get to it. Miscommunication there. Catcher had a bead. Pitcher was hesitant. First baseman was lost. And it'll let her drop. New life for Cole Tripp. I think the pitcher thought that was going to get out.
I think so, too.
And that wind held it up. That one gets away from the catcher, but no chance to advance on that. One ball, two strikes. That one misses.
Two and two. Excuse me. I can't believe I said Drake Moss. Remind me to do Drake up big time.
Oh, yeah. There's one ripped
to
third
base.
Oh,
nice play
by the third baseman. Throw to first is in time.
And the run will score.
And
that will bring up Drake Moss. Should I call him Drake Buffington?
Yeah, maybe that would even things out.
Coming up here, Blackcats, the pitcher number four. Yeah.
Moss steps in with the bases empty. Two outs. Bottom of the second. Nice breaking ball in there for strike one.
Swing and a miss. Strike two. Oh, the Lady Blackcats have tied it 4-4 in the bottom of the second with one out.
They got a cat fight going on over there.
That ball's ripped.
That fair.
That was a nice piece of
bases. He rounds first. He's going hard to second. Here comes the throw to the cutoff.
That's
going to
be an easy stand-up double.
Courtesy runner.
Courtesy runner for the pitcher. Number 15, Taylor Sims.
Taylor Sims.
Now ready for the Blackcats. First baseman, number 33, Levi Damon. Sometimes the only
life. Latest look at radar looks like we're pretty clean right now, Brian.
That's good.
Everything is still well west of the Mississippi. Hadn't got to Cape Girardeau yet. I know up north... technical support's dealing with it.
Yeah, she said they were in a tornado watch.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sure, yeah, she was blowing up your phone probably, wasn't she?
Yeah. Ball one to Levi. Levi with a base hit and an RBI first time up. JR was a beautiful piece of hitting.
Throw to second. Nope, fake.
By Levi the last time. The shortstop ran, for some reason, went to cover second instead of the second baseman.
Mm-hmm.
And Levi just hit it right where the shortstop was standing.
Was. Hit it where they ain't. That's what it's all about.
Ooh, up and in to Levi, ball two.
Actually, Levi charged the mound. I don't think Levi's got that in him.
Levi would charge it and shake his hand.
Yeah.
Levi,
thanks for giving me the base, sir.
Yeah.
Oh, they're really preoccupied with the runner down there at second. Yeah. Sims got their attention.
Here's the pitch.
Ball Levi asked for time, didn't get it.
That's
He'll
okay.
take the ball.
Ball three.
Speaking of that, did you see the Yankees the other day? Guy reached around and called timeout and didn't get it, and he hit a home run, and it didn't count.
Why?
Because he never gave him timeout. Or he did give him timeout.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, he did give him timeout. Yeah. That went in for strike one. Three balls, one strike.
Good take there by Levi. That ball was down.
And this time, another fake.
Spins and fakes. It's a fake throw.
Now, if we were in the major leagues, he wouldn't get to do that anymore.
No. Oh, got him.
Nope. Throws the ball into center field. Sims pops up. Center fielder's got it. Going to have a play here at third base. It's going to be close. And throws just a little offline. Sims steals the base.
E1. And Sims goes to third. Hey, you know one thing that I was telling Jenna, JR?
Just one thing?
Just one thing.
Yeah.
Saturday at the Saluki softball game, the guy's strike zone was about the big as a pie plate.
Wow.
But Salukis did score 20 runs because they were just sitting on it because they knew where it had to be a strike.
That one swung on a missed strike, too.
But I saw the quietest ejection I've ever saw Sunday.
Really?
The next thing we know, we're up there. The next thing we know, Evansville coach is getting tossed. We're like.
Must have been a little
directive
chatter from the
dugout. I guess so, because we never saw him, and he never got mad even on the ejection. He just was real polite about it, real calm, and it was hilarious.
Ball forward at Levi Damon. He's on first.
Yeah. Simmons. Nobody for your Black Cat.
Center fielder number 26, Nick Gower.
Nick Gower comes in. See if we can tack at least one more onto this lead. That one's fouled back. I got it. Did Scooter make it here today?
Yeah, I saw him run around to the playground earlier, but.
Okay. Just want to make sure I get the
I told him to make sure that he gets the count in.
Yep.
I missed Nick's walk-up music. I guess
next time. Ooh. That one swung on a miss back to the fence. No, they're going to say it was a foul ball.
I don't think it was.
I didn't think it was either. It looked like it just popped out of the glove. I didn't hear anything. Two strikes on Gower. Wind's about 93 miles an hour going straight. It was center field. Now it's ball over to the left. Now we got another balk. Oh, we're going to hear from the coach on this one. Another run for the Black Cats.
I wasn't watching.
Balk.
Got to stop.
Levi Damon's going to go down to second. That's going to take the force off. That lightens the load a little bit now for Gower. He definitely stopped.
He definitely did.
There's a ground ball down third baseline. Going to go foul.
Oh. No balls, two strikes, two away. Runner at second base. Gets the sign. Comes set.
Definitely stops. Here's the throw.
Nice
curveball
pitch.
Curveball in there for strike three. Buckled him at the knees. So Black Cats do pick up four runs after two innings. Black Cats lead 7-0 here on the BlackCatNetwork.com. Church has really got the face paint going, doesn't he?
Leading on top third inning for the Pioneers, right fielder number 22, Donovan Jimenez.
Jimenez steps in. 9-1-2 this inning for the Pioneers. Here's the pitch. Strike zone's opened up a little bit, Jenna, since that first inning. Yeah, first inning, it was very tight. One ball, one strike.
I got a text, and I think I know who it's from. It says, I like you two guys, but I have to say the girl softball announcer is way cuter
than
the baseball boys.
Probably Keisha.
Yeah.
It's got to be Keisha.
Yeah. Who wouldn't say that about her own son? And I'd have to probably agree.
Probably so. I think it's 2-2, Jenna.
I believe it is, too.
Huh?
Yeah, Brian and I have gotten kicked out of places before just for being ugly.
Yep. Ball high.
Going to fill it up at 3-2.
Full count.
And one of them was Church.
You know that old saying, ugly is sin?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We invented that. Oh, strike three. Hesitation on the call there.
I think he got hosed.
I would say that was he was definitely nibbling on that outside corner.
Nobody for the Pioneers. Shortstop number 12, Mason Cranawater.
Cranawater, I recognize that name from Trico.
Now make sure that one's cold because I just put some in there.
Oh, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good. Thank you.
We just restocked before the game, so make sure
cracking
you got a
cold my favorite one. Beverage here. Good old A&W Mountain or Root Beer.
Root Beer. One ball, no strikes, one away. Here's the pitch from Moss. Swing and a miss, strike two. Or strike one, I mean.
One, 1-1.
Cranawater walked the first time up, stole second, and was stranded at third. That ball's fouled back into the protective netting, strike two.
Oh, see, I knew I was going to start something by saying that. Now technical support's arguing the point.
Oh, she's arguing the point.
Yeah.
That ball's lifted high in the air.
Church says he's got to go ahead and play the win, and he really had to carry some ground. And they're going to call it safe.
It's going to be an
E5. That's why we use two hands, boys.
Yep.
I mean, that was a treacherous major league.
It was a tough play, but.
Nobody for the Pioneers, the catcher number 23, Bo Cohen.
He did circle. He looked like one of those circus poodles.
Yep. Cohen
walking on top of a ball on their back legs.
Cohen walked the first time up and then was got out on the double play to end the inning. Cranawater will be going here more than likely.
Timeout called by the batter.
4-4 after two across the street.
Good job, girls. Way to scratch back in that one. Trico got a tough softball team.
Yes, they do. Very good softball team. And the girls split with the tough Johnson City team as well.
Cranawater's on the move. He's heading down.
That's a foul ball.
It's going to be fouled.
Let it go, they say.
1-1 to count.
But Drake's going to grab it. Got plenty of time because Cranawater's just getting back. Huh?
By the way, we will have a vacancy in the Black Cat Network.
We will.
Well, we're going to think about this.
Oh, yeah, because
technical support is going to be relocating to Southern Illinois. Throw to first, not in time. In about 3 or 4 weeks.
Yeah. That's right.
So, and technical support will be accompanying the Black Cat Network
those
games. So, we will have an opening available. Somebody wants to be
nice
a part
move.
Of our crew. Good quick move. Cranawater has definitely got Moss's attention. I think Moss has got his attention now.
Yeah.
A couple of good moves there by Drake. timeout call. I got all kinds of
a lot of cat and mouse.
There's a chess game going on.
A lot of cat and mouse. They do it again. We're going to have Jenna fire up some organ music.
This is like a 3D chess game that they play on Star Trek.
That ball's lifted out to Buffington.
He's got it. Can he get him, double him up at first?
He couldn't quite get out his glove.
Couldn't make the transfer. He realized that Cranawater was a ways off. And I think Drake, if he could have made it clean, he'd have made that close.
Now, buddy, for the Pioneers, center fielder number 7, Ty Dorner.
Ty Dorner steps in.
Dorner bats out of the 3 spot in the lineup for the Pioneers.
He struck out swinging last
time.
Another
throw to first, not in time.
First time up.
There goes Crandall.
No.
Based on that, wants to have a chat.
So, JR, I was.
So, is that a warning for a buck? So, they're going to warn him. But they called the other guy. Go ahead. Go ahead.
No, I don't even know. And, yeah, the coach is not happy. No, I think somebody had called time.
There goes Cranawater. Throw down to second is.
Nice. Got him!
Yes, in time. Black Cats retire the Pioneers here in the top of the third. We'll go to the bottom of the third. Black Cats lead 7-0 here on the BlackCatNetwork.com.
Tyler Sue stepped in. The base hit the first time up. Black Cats lead 7-0 here in the bottom of the third inning. First pitch, Suits rips that one in the 5-6 hole and gets a base hit, and we'll get things started again.
That's the way to start an inning. Oh, yeah, you laid it on. That was a good one. Courtesy runner here for the catcher Suits. That's Hester. Will Hester.
Courtesy runner for the catcher number 3, Will Hester.
Hester in to run. Buffington grounded out to second base the first time up. Buffington with a huge home run against Vianna to send it to extra innings at Vianna last week. Or 2 weeks ago. And it's been 2 weeks ago already.
And I understand Buff pitched a good outing this last weekend, too. Was that against Benton, maybe?
Yeah. Benton or Edwards, I don't remember. I wasn't there, so you'd have to ask Jenna that. Ball out. Two balls, no strikes. Runner first. Blackcats looking to lead to add to this lead.
Byerman a little hesitant to come at the 6 foot 9 inch Buffington.
Drake's a big boy. Hester with a big lead down there. Catcher's got a good arm though. I mean,
yeah,
he hoes suits out. So there's a strike.
Pretty much taken.
Yeah, 3-1. Jenna's over there doing crazy stuff with the scoreboard. Here's the pitch. That ball is ripped.
Yes, it is, and lifted to left center. It's going, it's going, it's going, it's gone. Home run for Drake Buffington. Two-run homer in the top or the bottom of the third. Puts the Black Cats up 9-0. That was sky high. I mean, he got under that.
Number the Green Black Cats, third baseman number 31, Garrett Church.
Church steps in now. Base is empty, nobody out. That one bounces across for ball one.
Makes it 9-0.
9-0, 9-0, 9-0. Take that pitch for strike one. Yeah, Church looks like Batman with that eye paint. He got it going on. That one. Bounce back to your living room. Two balls, one strike.
Shakes him off.
Delivers. Curveball? Nope.
Oh, nice spot.
Yeah, it was. I don't know. It missed by much.
Three balls and a strike to Church.
They gave him a dirty ball. I can't pick that one up as easy as I did the other one.
No.
Yeah, it's getting a little darker here.
Yeah, that's why Jenna turned the lights on.
That one bounces across, and that'll be ball four for Garrett Church. Going to have a little break in the action.
Yeah.
I think we're going to have a pitching change. Looks like maybe the first baseman running to the dugout to get another glove. Yeah, pitcher going to take the ball from him. Just a swap out, looks like first. And the pitcher.
And we'll take a quick break. Here watching the Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com.
So Estelle steps on the mound now for the Trico Pioneers. Blackcats here with no outs. And that ball's going to squirt to the fence, and Church is going to scoot down to second base. So it looks like at least rain is just over Cape Girardeau right now.
Yep.
And what do you got to have four in to make a complete game?
Yep.
So at what point, Brian, do you say, hey, guys, we need to,
I don't know.
Get some outs and finish this game, make sure it gets in. You don't want to rain out in this situation.
No.
And once it starts, there won't be any coming back. And the thing of it is, too, it doesn't just have to be rain. It's the lightning.
Yeah.
Where you
automatically because every strike is a 30-minute delay.
Exactly. That one's popped to center field.
That ball's carrying.
It sure is. Center fielder back.
Dorner makes a great play.
Yes, he did.
Great throw, too.
Church tags up and gets the third. That ball really carried. That looked like it was deep second. Top of the order for the Black Cats. Francis drives one right to third.
Hits that ball hard. Nice play by the third baseman.
Made the put out. Almost double play. That still looks more like a pitcher that's going to allow you to put it in play and let his defense make the plays.
Two away now. Runner at third.
First pitch misses for strike one.
Swing and a miss. One ball, one strike. Cole's 1-for-2 today with a double and a couple runs batted in.
It's a good day's work. That one squirts outside in the dirt.
Two balls and a strike. Drake Moss waits on deck.
That's going to get down. Base hit into center field for Cole Tripp. Here at Church trots home. Gives 10 runs to the Black Cats.
Moss 2-for-2 today with a double and a single.
Halfway to the cycle.
Halfway. We'll definitely be stretching after this fourth
yes.
inning.
Yes, yeah. Ball hit off the fist for strike two.
No balls, two strikes. Lady Blackcats trail 7-4 as they hit to the bottom of the third. That top part of Trico's softball's lineup is just
pretty salty, aren't
it? It is very 1-5 is just tough.
Ooh, the wind's a howling. Oh, strike on the inside corner.
That should be
That's
three.
Yeah. Moss is incredulous on that one.
Blackcats get three
but going to have to take strike three, go to the bench, go out and stop them here.
Blackcats 10,
I think we're going to hand this over to Jenna, aren't we? After this inning, we'll hand it over to Jenna here on the BlackCatNetwork.com.
Field. Number 8, Zach Green.
Zach Green in the ball game.
Now batting for the Pioneers. Center fielder number 7, Ty Dorner.
Dorner steps to the plate here in the top of the 4th.
Ball outside. Dorner struck out swinging his first time up. Dorner made a heck of a catch there in the bottom half that inning.
Yes, he did.
Swing and a miss. Strike one.
Nice change of pace there for a nice change up for Moss. Pushes the count to 1-1. Misses in. 2 balls, 1 strike.
There's strike two.
2-2 your count.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
And strike 3 got him looking. Good pitching there by Moss.
Nobody for the Pioneers. Designated hitter number 33, Cannon Wilson.
Moss looks very relaxed out there on the mound today. He's really feeling in the groove.
Boost, definitely.
Good breaking ball for strike one.
Yeah, his pitch count's going down every inning since the first inning.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta get ahead, stay ahead. It's the name of the game.
It's a game of life, man. Ooh, just missed that side. 1 ball, 2 strikes. So we're back here tomorrow night, I believe, Mark O'Brien.
Yep, weather permitting. Strike 3.
I think.
Now batting for the Pioneers, first baseman number 18, Kyler Bowerman.
If my cobweb brain reminds me correctly, I think Carrier Mills is coming.
That's correct, sir. Carrier Mills. Moss just getting ahead, man.
He is.
He's just pumping.
Yeah, you can tell by his rhythm out there on the mound. If he was skipping rocks, he'd get 20 skips out of it right now.
I think so.
That one's driven to center field. And there for the put out. Going to be 3 outs and go to the bottom of the 4th. I think we're going to hand this over to Jenna now as we stretch.
Levi Damon
steps in. First batter here in the bottom of the 4th. Black Cats lead 10-0. Takes first pitch for ball 1.
That ball is up. Lady Black Cats trail 7-4 after 3 innings. That ball's fouled back. Strike one.
Almost got Gower there in the on-deck circle. Yeah.
Nice breaking ball.
It was.
Nice breaking ball.
Levi rips one down the line.
Is it going to stay fair?
Oh!
It cleared the fence by a mile. It was halfway in the parking lot. Home plate umpire calls it foul. Yeah, I don't know. It was curving.
Thank you, sir.
You betcha. Thank Jenna.
One ball, two strikes.
Do it again. 3 feet to the right.
Levi feet away from a solo home run.
He definitely put the mojo on that wall.
Battling.
Down the left side.
Into the bullpen.
Foul. Two balls, two strikes. The count.
Levi steps in.
Hanging tough.
Yep.
Waits on that breaking ball. The catcher thinks he's got it. He circles. He's got umping his
way.
Nice play.
Nice play.
Nice grab. He made the complete 360 for out number one.
Nobody bears like that. Center fielder number 26, Nick Gower.
Good job by Cohen behind the plate there on that. That's tough. That's a tough play.
Toughest play in baseball right there. And softball.
Another pop-up. This one's down to right side. Catcher thinks he can get them all. He can't get to that one.
Oh.
Wind almost blew that back in.
Blew it back in. Strike one.
If you hit it to us, it may stay in play. If you hit it to the shortstop, it may carry out.
Mm-hmm.
Wind's now going to dead center.
Ball out.
One ball, one strike. All right. Technical support's asked a question, Brian.
I have an answer.
Why do they call it the bullpen?
What do they call it, the bullpen?
Yes. Got to be a reason for
it. It's got to be a reason.
There's got to be an origin.
Well.
Jenna? Jenna's trying to make something up.
Yeah.
I know how her mind works. There's a ground ball down.
Oh, that's
going to
be an E5.
Right through the wickets. Throw is not in time to first. And Gower legs that one out. Tyler Suits is going to come in now with the runner on first. Out here in the bottom of the fourth.
Here.
That ball is.
Oh, nice play.
Throw to second in time. Throw to first is not. So they'll get the force out for the second out of the inning.
And run for the Blackcats, number three, Will Bester. Now batting for the Blackcats.
Okay, why do they call it a bullpen? Yeah, I like this. Previously, in the late 19th century, latecomers to ball games were cordoned off into standing room areas in foul territory because the fans were herded like cattle. This area became known as the bullpen, the designation which became retained when those areas became the spot where relief pitchers would warm up. I would not have thought that. There's a ground ball down third baseline, going to go foul. Strike two. It's an odd little thing. I mean, it's really taken on a life of its own. Everybody knows what a bullpen is.
Yeah.
It's identifiable. Once again, Black Cat fans are the most important fans.
Oh, that was a strike.
In the United States.
That's right.
One ball, two strikes. That one's hit hard to the shortstop. He's going to come up, throw to second in time for the force out.
Blackcats get no runs on no hits, one error.
So Blackcats will see if they can finish things off here in the top of the fifth. They lead 10-0 here on the BlackCatNetwork.com.
Lead off top the fifth
inning for the Pioneers, the pitcher number 25, Cade Escobar.
There's a squibber ground ball down third baseline. Green charges, tries to get scoop it with one, throw to first. In time. Not sure if he got him on the throw or the tag.
I don't know, but we'll take
it. Good job by Church there.
Now batting for the Pioneers, third baseman number 35, Caden McBride.
Never give up on a play.
Nope.
Never give up. Not till the fat lady sings. That one is lifted to left. It's in a bad spot.
Oh.
It's going to drop.
You know what that was?
A ball with eyes.
No, well, that, but it was also the first hit of the game.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Now that's going to ruin this. Left number 11,
so,
Caden Starkey.
So now we can say it.
We can say it.
Yeah, I wasn't even aware.
Yeah.
Of the no hits.
That was the first hit of the game.
My mom. Yeah, he's a little, yeah, I can see it in his face now.
He's pissed.
Yeah. You're going to take it out on this guy right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, Moss has been really, really comfortable on that mound today.
Ball high.
Just a little bit high. Missed by a cat's whisker. There's a shot to the shortstop. Throw to first is not in time. Gets away. And runners are going to stay at first.
I don't think he throws him out if he catches.
I don't think that's another hit.
I think that's another. Yeah. So now you don't feel bad. It's two hits. So.
Yeah.
Now batting for the Pioneers, right fielder number 22, Donovan Jimenez.
So Pioneers, bottom part of the lineup, trying to get something going here in the late innings.
Swing and a miss, strike one.
With runners on first and second, one out. Mossett and delivers. Swung on a miss, strike two. And swing and miss, strike three.
Two away. Brings up top of the order.
Now batting for the Pioneers, shortstop number 12, Mason Cranewater.
Now, Cranewater's been on two times, am I not correct in assuming?
Yeah, a walk and an error.
And they're going to call timeout?
No, you're going to say you balked.
Oh, we got a balk. That's the favorite call of the day, folks. That's the, what, the third balk that's been called?
Yep.
And a warning. Takes the force off out of play. First pitch misses high, ball one. That ball's lifted down the left field line.
And
be out of play.
Foul.
Over there by the peanut gallery.
Just a long stride.
In front of the buses.
I'm still not for sure why that was a balk.
Don't know.
Ball outside. Three balls and a strike to Cronawater.
I was hoping to end this threat right here.
Yeah.
Ooh, generous call on the outside.
That
corner.
Was a gift. That was a gift.
Full count. 3-2, two outs. Top of the fifth.
And ball down the dirt, walked him. That brings up Bo Cohen.
Now batting for the Pioneers, the catcher number 23, Bo Cohen.
Cohen has walked and flew out to right field. Ball outside.
Well, struggling a little bit here yep. Now, all of a sudden.
There's a swing and a miss.
It's what, this is the third time through the lineup?
Yeah.
That makes a difference, too. Batters kind of get more accustomed to what to expect. That one misses, goes to the backstop, and nobody advances.
It's the advantage of the short backstop.
Two balls, one strike.
Two balls, one strike, two away, bases loaded, no room at the end. Swing and a miss, strike two.
Well, he was swinging for the fence that time. Oh, just misses outside. Going to fill it up.
Everybody be running. Dig deep here, Drake.
Time called by the batter. Mossa looking for somebody to take off running. And there go the runners. Misses outside. It's going to be the first run now for Trico.
Somebody from the Pioneers, center fielder number 7, Ty Dorner.
Dorner 0 for 2 today.
Bases are loaded. That pitch in for a strike.
Dorner struck out swinging and struck out looking.
Breaking ball misses outside 1-1.
One ball, one away.
There's a pop up to left field. It's carrying.
It's a grand slam.
That's a grand slam. And just like that, Trico's got five runs on the board here in the fifth inning.
I think we stretched too early.
I think we might have two. Grand slammer for Ty Dorner, center fielder. All of a sudden, we got a ball game.
Yep.
It's 10-5.
Now batting for the Pioneers, designated hitter number 33, Cannon Wilson.
First pitch in there for strike one.
Moss was cruising along and gave up that first hit, and it just kind of went downhill from there.
Kind of like walking along in the field and creeping up on a snake you don't see.
Yeah. One ball, one strike. That ball's hit foul out of play.
I think that was a bus. One ball, two strikes. And he takes strike three. It's going to end the inning. Trico Pioneers do get five runs, though, make it 10-5. We're going to go to the bottom of the fifth here on the BlackCatNetwork.com. Cranawater is going to take over the pitching duties for Trico. And then they've got some other changes we're going to have to get caught up on here. The first pitch is in there for ball one.
Yeah, they don't. Sean even told him, how's the official book? You need to signal to the press box.
He didn't even signal you at all. He didn't give you a second thought, Brian. Next pitch misses ball two. So it's kind of weird with it. I mean, the game looked like it was going to be in hand.
Yeah.
You know, and then all of a sudden, bang. So it's odd to say with a 5-0 or 5-10 lead, the Blacks need Black Cats need a comeback.
Yep. So who's at short now?
35. That pitch in there for a strike, one ball, and or three balls, one strike.
18's at, what number's at third? 18?
Looks like 18. Okay. That ball is lifted foul and out of play. Fills the count, 3-2.
Three balls, two strikes.
Church fouls that one off. Just got a piece, got under it just a little bit. Still full. That one is driven to the left center, but the left right center fielder's right there. He was shading that direction. Wind's not blowing near as hard as it was earlier. C.J. Trevilian steps in now for the first time tonight. Here in the bottom of the fifth. First pitch swung on a miss, strike one.
Ball down. One ball, one strike.
That ball has popped up to center on his horse.
Doesn't quite
get
there.
Yeah, that's what you get for shading that far to the left. Well, nobody going to run that down. Base hit for C.J. Trevilian. So now Hunter Francis, at the top of the lineup, comes to bat. Gonna have a courtesy runner,
pinch runner. Probably re-enter the game. Yep.
In run for the Black Cats, double zero. Grant Crock.
Grant Crock comes it back in the ball game.
Run a little bit better speed there.
Yep.
Good job by CJ getting on base.
Yes, it was. Put it right where they weren't.
That's what you got to do, Joe. Good swing by Francis.
Yeah, he really wanted. He'd like to have that pitch back.
Hunter Francis, 2-for-3 today. Hit that shot to the third baseman back in the third inning. But led the game off with a ground rule double, singled. Got an RBI. Might see him hit that right center field gap.
Yeah, with the speed to be out there on the bases, you could figure that'll produce.
One ball, one strike.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that one right off the ankle. Or top of the foot or someplace which was not comfortable.
That was definitely not comfortable.
Coach Tripp going to talk to him a little bit.
Yeah, let's.
All right, give him a minute.
Let's.
Hunter's laughing, so. Next count, one ball, two strikes. Crock on first. Francis at the plate. One out, bottom of the fifth. Breaking ball.
Oh.
Is in there for strike three.
Not so sure about that.
I'm not either.
Coming in for Black Cat, shortstop number 12, Cole Tripp.
Tripp drives one to left field. Left fielder back. Center fielder's over. Makes a grab at the fence.
Oh, nice play.
At the fence.
Black Cats get no runs on one hit.
That was out of here.
We played five. Black Cats 10.
Black Cats come up empty handed. 10-5, we go to the top of the sixth. So Black Cats will pace the 5, 6, and 7 spot in the lineup.
That ball gets out of play. Off the top of the school bus.
Nailed it. Nailed it. Dead center. Just a long strike.
Nice change up there by Moss. 0-2.
Coach Tripp leaves Moss in here. And strike three. Tag him out just to make sure.
Yep.
Now batting for the Pioneers. The pitcher number 20. No longer the pitcher. Now number 25, Cade Estel.
Yeah. Wherever he's playing,
I don't know
his number is still 25.
I don't know where he's at.
He's right there in the batter's box. Calls timeout.
He's at first.
Now okay. Who's on first? Who's on first? First pitch misses outside, ball one.
Okay. Yeah, nobody told me, so. That ball's lifted.
Pop-up should stay in.
No.
Oh! Right off. Jenna, are you all right? It hit her right on the top of the melon. And look, her eyes straightened out.
Mm.
One ball, one strike. There, I make that two strikes.
Now
that was strike three.
Shortstop number 35.
I guess I missed one somewhere. Two outs for Moss. And there's a ball that's probably going to get down.
Yeah.
Just out there in no man's land.
And Caden McBride, who broke up the no-hitter, gets another hit.
Well, that's enough of that.
Now batting for the Pioneers, left fielder number 11, Caden Starkey.
Starkey also with a base hit last inning.
Yeah, this was the bottom part of the order that caused us some problems last time through.
Oh, good pitch. First,
good pitch. Just misses outside, I guess. Ball one. Right back into your living room, 1-1.
Nice pitch.
Good breaking ball in there for strike two. There's a ground ball underneath the glove of Moss. Gets to the second baseman. Flipped to second for the force out. And the Tricol Pioneers will go down with no runs that inning. Blackhats come up the bottom of the sixth. Leading 10-5 here on the BlackCatNetwork.com.
Leading off the bottom of the sixth inning for your Blackcats, pitcher number four,
So Moss will step in here in the bottom of the sixth. See if we can add on to this lead or just score five ourselves and go home. That'd be nice. Waiting on the home plate umpire. We don't need to be waiting. There's rain coming. Come on, let's go.
He's taking his own sweet time, ain't he?
He is.
Lady Blackcats trail 7-4 after 5.
They've been stuck on that for a while. That one's grounded to the shortstop. Tries to backhand it. Knocks it down. Throw to first. It's going to be wild.
It's
going to
be
an E6. Yeah. Moss is going to stay on first. Levi Damon fouls the first one off. Strike one.
Gower's on deck. Gower going to re-enter and hit.
Moss.
Or he never left. I mean, Nicky came in.
Right.
Yeah.
Moss got a healthy lead over there.
So Levi re-enters for Nicky. Yeah.
Bowerman giving Moss a good look there after that pitch, yeah. Thinking about firing down to first.
No balls, one strike to Levi.
This is 1-1. There's a ground ball down third baseline. Goes off the third baseman's glove. Moss rounds, but he's not going to be able to advance. I give that a hit.
Yeah, he hit it pretty hard.
Yeah, he did. It would have been a tough play. Even if he comes up, well, yeah. Yeah, it would have been a tough play.
Coming for your Blackcats, number 26.
I'm telling you, we're going to get that five spot and go home. Now we got a courtesy runner.
Yeah. Well, he's going to re-enter. Should be Nicky back in, right? Oh, that's right.
Jason Sims.
In row for the Blackcats, number 15.
Taylor Sims.
I should call him Jason.
Jason, that's what
better than calling him Jenna. Is it really?
Well, that's why I called him that then.
JT. Mm-hmm. Huh? He does like that?
I got one of those myself. They're pretty good kids.
Well, ball outside. The nice thing is we can just leave this set up, but if we get rained out, then I got to come back Thursday and get it all to take to the ground.
That one's down the right field line. That could get down. If it stays in,
it's
going to.
It's fair ball. It's
going
to be a hit.
Outfielder overruns it, and everybody's going to advance one base. Because of its location, we couldn't get the run in on that.
No,
because
you had to hold up.
That's going to load the bases. I'm telling you, we're going to get that five spot.
Nobody here at Blackcats. The catcher number 2, Tyler Suits.
And Suits is going to get started right here.
And Drake going to re-enter.
And Buffington's getting ready to come back in. Yeah, Coach Tripp wants to get this over with. Suits takes first pitch up and in, ball one.
Base is loaded, nobody out. Ball one.
Ball one.
Ball one. Oh, good.
Right off the fists.
One ball, one strike.
Did you have a good weekend, Brian?
Yeah, I had Saluki softball Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
I got a chance to watch some of that on ESPN.
Did you?
The Ocho.
Could you hear me?
I could. Right there on national television. Yeah. Brian Murley in the background. All professional in life. I'm telling you, man, that pitcher.
Maddie is pretty
awesome.
What'd
she have, 15 strikeouts?
15 strikeouts, 10 in a row.
Man. Yeah, she was throwing BBs. Yeah, one misses down. Three balls, one strike.
Yeah, she came in after Hannah Hockerman started the game and got a little wild. Coach Sewell said, no, no, we're not having that. She came in, gave up a fly ball, then scored, struck out 10 in a row.
That's stealthy.
Yeah, she was bringing it. And, of course, they throw out T-shirts after every strikeout at Charlotte West. And so the guy after the game, I asked him, so how's your arm? He goes, oh, a little tired today.
I'm surprised he had enough.
Yeah, we were getting concerned. We were down close to being out that day.
There's a ball lifted to center field. He's got a bead on it, it looks like. Makes the catch. It's going to bring one home for sure.
Yeah.
And just a long sacrifice fly, but Black Cats get a run.
Now, for your Black Cats, number 11, Buffington.
So Buffington will step in. He's already gone yard once tonight.
Yeah, it'd be nice if he did it again.
It would be. Cats with runners at first and second. Good speed on the bases. That one misses outside. Low. Ball one.
Buffington looking to add to his three RBIs on the day.
Yep. And that one's carrying its left. It's going. It's gone. Another home run for Drake Buffington. Telling you, we're going to.
I pissed him off when I said Moss.
You call him Moss more often. Two homers for Drake Buffington. Cats looking to scratch one more out. We can wrap this thing up. Pushes the score to 5-14. Here at the bottom of the sixth.
Girls are down now 9-4.
9-4. Breaking ball misses.
Buffington with 6 RBIs on the day.
Wow. 2 homers, 6 RBIs.
What was that pitch?
Ball. Two balls, no strikes.
6 RBIs on the day.
Wow.
That's two bombs.
That's a great deal.
That one's out of play. We'll do it again.
Scooter, where you been, bud? I was afraid you weren't. Okay. I do have the official attendance here from our own Mr. Scooter. Been out counting heads. Today's official attendance, 2,642 and 3 dogs.
Oh, wow.
That foul ball evens the count at 2-2. Thank you, Scooter. Here, take a Reese's with you.
Garrett's going to find the hole.
Yeah, he does, right over the second baseman's head. Base hit representing the winning run down there. Gonna have another courtesy runner. We are. Number one, Mason Dunn.
Good run for the Black Cats. Number one, Mason Dunn.
Now ball outside. Well, it's getting dark.
It is.
Yeah, I got to get home, get the dogs put up, and get the vehicles in the barn.
Second pitch in there for a strike, 1-1. Yeah, for some reason, my radar is not
pulling up.
My Storm Track 3 radar.
I blame it on J.C. Brienne.
No, I wouldn't blame anything on her. No. She's too nice of a young lady.
She is a great
nice
lady.
Pop up there.
Oh, speaking of Channel 3.
Yes.
Guess who I saw this weekend and had a chance to talk with? Former Channel 3.
Oh, Kelly Burke?
Yeah,
there's another one who went to ESPN. I can't remember her name.
Well, no. Well, she was not at ESPN.
Oh.
She just recently.
There's a ground ball to the third baseman. Picked up, throw to first, is down in the dirt and unable to come up with it. Black Cats are going to have the winning run now on third base.
Five or three, Jenna?
Five.
That's what I thought. Oh, no, Miss Gabby Sorrentini.
Ah, okay.
Now ready for the Black Cats. Shortstop number 12, Cole Trip.
I'm sure she asked about me.
She did. She got a job, and she's going to be the sports anchor out in Cincinnati.
Good for her. Good for her.
It's good seeing her.
Francis with a healthy lead over at first now. There he goes. They're going to throw for
him. And that's going to be the ball game.
And that's going to end the ball game. Run will score. Puts the Cats up 10. And they will win by 10 run rule. So the Black Cats pull out the W. It looked like a game that was going to be well in hand, a no-hitter for quite a while into the fifth inning for Drake Moss. And the Pioneers hang five on the Black Cats and make it 10-5. Black Cats are able to bottom of the sixth to stretch that back out to a 10-run lead and finish the ball game. We're going to have a word from our sponsors and be back with a little post-game and some stats here on the BlackCatNetwork.com.
Southern Trust Bank, only bank in Johnson County that is locally owned. Community banks touch every corner of our lives. They support us as we turn our life's goals into accomplishments. Goals like going to college, opening a small business, buying a home, planning a wedding, or having a baby. For your first car to life after retirement, our community bank is there for all your life's milestones. Southern Trust Bank is located in Goreville, Vienna, and Marion. Come out and visit the friendly faces at your local branch. FDIC Equal Housing Lender. Black Cat alum Noel Pease is proud to have his company Pease Contracting LLC support the Black Cat Network. Noel can handle any and all of your needs when it comes to lawn care, landscape, snow removal, or excavation. Reach out to Noel at 618-364-5140 for a free estimate. For grass, gravel, snow, or dirt, use Pease Contracting at a price that won't hurt. Don't get caught late in the game and find yourself running out of your favorite adult beverage. Stock up in advance by visiting The Oasis, conveniently located just north of Goreville on Route 37. The Oasis prides itself on providing a large variety and quality selection of adult beverages, including hard-to-find allocated spirits. If they don't carry what you're looking for, just ask. They'd be happy to try to get it for you. You'll experience quality, service, and convenience at The Oasis. The Oasis, a must stop before your next adult gathering. The Goreville News is a supporter of the Black Cats Network and exclusively covers the Goreville Black Cats athletic program. If you have any news about Goreville, the Lake of Egypt, or surrounding area, let's tell the world and email them at contact@gorevillenews.com. The Goreville News, your only Goreville newspaper. This year, more than ever, make sure you're well stocked with all your game time munchie needs. And you can do that by shopping locally and supporting small businesses, just like the Goreville Food Market. Conveniently located in the heart of Goreville, just down from the city park, the Goreville Food Market has everything you need to make streaming your Black Cat sporting event experience a great success. The Goreville Food Market offers a full grocery experience and boasts the best quality butcher department around that serves only fresh meat, never frozen. They're open 7 days a week for your convenience. Come visit the Goreville Food Market. Dean Harper Auction is pleased once again to sponsor the Black Cat Network. Dean Harper Auction has been in business since 1967 and does both online auction as well as live auctions. They can help you sell your estate, household, real estate, as well as your farm. You can contact Dean Harper Auction at www.deanharperauction.com. Give Robin or Dean a call at 618-527-6500 for a no-cost consultation. Dean Harper Auction, serving Johnson County and the surrounding area, as well as supporting your Goreville Black Cats. Remember, everything sells with Harper. Have you got a commercial or home project that requires more equipment and muscle than you have available? Well, you don't have to break your back to get the job done. You can save time and money with Suits Equipment Rental. Suits Equipment Rentals has all the tools and equipment you'll need to tackle any project, big or small. Call them today at 618-992-4433. Timber! If you have a need for attention to any tree issues on your property, Shawnee Tree Services is here to help. The folks at Shawnee Tree Services are arbor care specialists, providing all types of tree services for Johnson County and the surrounding areas. Whether it's a simple tree trimming or complete removal, Shawnee Tree Service has the answer for you. Contact them today at 618-694-6343. Why would you call anyone else? Once again, Wiffle Boys Pizza is the official pizza of the Black Cats Network. The Southern Illinois original, located in the heart of downtown Goreville, offers pizza, subs, salads, soups, wings, and appetizers. You can place your order the old-timey way by phone at 618-995-9433 or order online. Download the Wiffle Boys app, available through Android and iOS, and look in the Apple Store or Google Play. They've also added a lunch menu and are open for lunch Wednesdays through Sunday at 11 o'clock. Call them now at 618-995-9433. Wiffle Boys Pizza, hometown, homegrown, and always homemade.
Absolutely always homemade. Hey, Goreville has a new option for a home-cooked breakfast or lunch at the Goreville Grill. Located right behind H&H Fuel across from Wiffle Boys, the Goreville Grill offers a full breakfast and lunch menu, including biscuits and gravy, the Black Cat Burger, and homemade pies. They're open Monday through Friday from 6 to 2, Saturday from 6 to 11. Call ahead at 618-964-0105, and you can pick up your meal at their drive-thru. Check out the daily lunch specials posted on the Facebook page, the Goreville Grill. Friendly service, quality food, and just like Brian Murley, made with love. The Black Cats get a big Black Diamond victory tonight. They walk away victors 15-5, as we mentioned before. Game was well in hand. No hitter in play after five innings. Looked like it was going to be a 10-run rule, and a couple of base hits and a couple of walks, and then one monster towering fly ball to left that cleared the fence. Next thing you know, Trico put up a five spot. Kind of extended the ball game. Black Cats came up empty-handed in the bottom of the fifth, continued to hold Trico scoreless, and then in the sixth inning was able to recapture five runs. Majority of those came off the bat of one Mr. Buffington. Drake Buffington with two homers today, six RBIs. If you can tell, I'm stretching this out because Brian is frantically trying to run total stats over here.
All right, I think I'm ready.
Are you ready to go?
Yeah.
Give me some numbers.
All right. Drake Moss today pitched six innings, had 22 at-bats against him, gave up four hits, five runs. They were all earned.
Yeah, I think they were earned.
They were all earned. Only walked one. That ain't right. No, he walked four. He walked four, struck out 10, gave up a home run, had a balk. The big hitter for Trico was Caden McBride, two for three, the run driving in. But then you're talking about Ty Dorner with the grand slam, really got them back in the ball game. He was 1 for 3 with 4 RBIs and a home run. For the Black Cats, Hunter Francis, 3 for 5, 2 runs scored, an RBI and a double. Cole Tripp, 2 for 4 with a run scored, 2 RBIs and a double. Drake Moss, 2 for 4 with 3 runs scored and a double. Levi Damon, 2 for 3 today with a run scored and an RBI. Nick Gower, 1 for 4 with a run scored. Tyler Suits, 2 for 3 with a run scored and an RBI. As you mentioned, Drake Buffington, 2 for 3 with 2 runs scored and 6 RBIs, a 3-run bomb and a 2-run bomb. Garrett Church was 1 for 2 today with 3 runs scored, got on base 3 times today, hit by pitch and a walk and then a single. Grant Kroc, 0 for 1 today, and C.J. Trevelyan, 1 for 1 today. So, good outing by the Black Cats.
Top to bottom, good outing by the Black Cats. Yep. I was impressed.
Yeah, Black Cats will be back again in action tomorrow, the cardboard, and weather permitting, and we'll be back on air tomorrow at around 4:20, 4:25 or so. But we thank you all for joining us here today on Black Cats Network. Black Cats Network is a free service of Gorville School. If you'd like more information about Black Cats Network, you can contact us on our Facebook page or email us at blackcatsnetwork@gmail.com or contact@gorvilleschools.com. For Brian Murley and J.R. Russell. Good night, everyone.
Good night, everybody.